Hi, guys. Moaning Myrtle here. I am on my way to day one of Rose City Comic Con. Happy Friday the 13th. Oh my goodness. Wow, I am so excited. So as you can see, I am cosplaying as Moaning Myrtle from Harry Potter. Today there is a Ravenclaw House meetup. I'm looking forward to that. And there'll be a couple panels, possibly, depending on how the day goes. So let's go to the Oregon Convention Center and enjoy day one of Rose City Comic Con.
Flying so close to where we belong, and we're trying to go somewhere new. And I try to crack this iceberg open till it shatters through the ocean. I wanna make shockwaves, I wanna make shockwaves with you. Gonna move the ocean current till the waves flood what's been burning. I wanna make shockwaves. I wanna make shockwaves with you. And I know I'm only getting higher, till it feels like I can walk through fire.
trying to step back and see the view from above. Cause I know that nothing lasts forever. And I try to crack this iceberg open till it shatters through the ocean. I wanna make shockwaves. I wanna make shockwaves with you. Gonna move the ocean current till the waves flood what's been burning. I wanna make shockwaves. I wanna make shockwaves.
I know this guy.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, it's Comics with Bueller.
That's right.
Shockwaves with you. Shockwaves with you.
Shockwaves with you. Segue into you and your bandmates have been together for a really long time, and what's the secret to staying together? And since you and Pauly Shore are still both here at Rose City Comic Con, do you have plans to get together?
I had made plans to hang out with Pauly Shore. I think they're having a big dinner for everybody tomorrow night, so maybe I'll see him there, so I don't know. In terms of the secret of keeping the band together for this long, I'm just lucky. I found some really amazing guys very early on in my career. I don't know what to attribute to besides luck, but they're all extremely talented. They're some of the best musicians in the world. And they're just nice, decent, down-to-earth guys. I mean, there's no drama on the road. We don't have any, like, behind-the-music moments. We're not stabbing each other with forks, you know? We just get along super well, you know, we just really respect and enjoy each other's company.
Question over here.
Well, I've seen the Will and Kirby crossover with Phineas and Ferb, and with the movie being announced, I need to know, are you going to be in that one?
Am I allowed to say? I did a voice or two for the movie. It's a very small. I'm not. You're going to blink and miss it, but I am in the movie, but I can't tell you what.
Thank you.
Two movies that messed me up for life. Well, actually, I watched all of them, which really messed me up. One was actually Hellraiser, if you remember that. Whew, right there. And the other, of course, was the Nightmare on Elm Street franchise. Without further ado, Mr. Robert Englund, come on up!
Like Harry Elwes and Lou and everybody, like a lot of pals around. And it's always good, people think they think we all sit around in Schwab's drugstore on Sunset Boulevard, all the horror actors and all the actors. But we never see each other except when we work together or at times like this, because we live all over in different places, all over California or the US. And it's kind of fun to, you know, reconnect with everybody.
When you, in terms of what you got to take with you from the set, there were multiple gloves, correct? And you have, do you have several of them still in your, no.
The no. Orange, excuse me, did I just burp? It's the peanut butter cup from the green room. A shameless plug. The original glove, Wes Craven took home. And Wes was living in an airy, a beautiful home at the top of the highest peaks in the Hollywood Hills. It had been Steve McQueen's bachelor pad. And Wes had changed the pool into a lap pool and done some reworking of it. And it was just the best place to visit. And Wes had the glove there with some rare stuff from the first movie. And when we shot part two, we needed new pickup shots. And they're like Freddy's hands scraping on a wall and a close-up of me in the makeup and feet walking downstairs. We were in like an MTV stage in LA. And Wes loaned the original glove to Jack Shoulder to use for the pickup shots. Because I think there was a close-up of the claw, and he wanted it to be authentic, and Jack did. So I had heard, and this is a fanboy story, by then, the jungle drums were kind of beating loud that we were onto something really special, and that our franchise might be around for a while. But this is still early in that awareness. And we had been told that there might be some industrial espionage spies from Fango magazine, Fangoria, trying to get the glove. And lo and behold, there were guys who were fanboys pretending to be grips. Now, the way you could tell was that their tool belts were brand new. And we knew they weren't. They didn't know whether a Makita from a hole in the ground. And you could use a Makita to put a hole. But anyway, so I, at the end of the shoot, I took the glove. Remember now, this is, Nightmare 2 has not even been released yet. All I know for sure is that Nightmare 1 has been international, you know, but I don't know how many we're going to make. I never in my wildest dreams expected to do 8 of them. And so I took the glove and I thought, well, you know, I'll give it to my agent. You know, he's just renegotiated for me on a little TV show I was doing called V. And and I stuffed the glove and I mounted it in plexiglass, probably 2 inches thick, plexi, wide, I mean. And I outlined it in red and green neon. And I gave it to my agent. And that's where the original glove is, yeah. It's in his office, in his home.
Red and green was an interesting color choice and perhaps a deliberate one.
Yeah, I wish Wes was here to tell you. Wes had done some research about the colors of red and green being disconcerting in a hypnotic state. I mean, it's easy to think, oh, it's the colors of Christmas, but it's also the colors of the chilies that you eat in New Mexico, and it's many, many other things, but they vibrate together. And not a psychedelic way, in a kind of a spiraling, hypnotic M.C. Escher design way. And I think that's the reason Wes selected that for the sweater. The strange thing is I get hundreds of crayon drawings sent to my home from all over the world, from children. And they haven't seen the movies, don't get alarmed. Mom, Dad, don't get alarmed.
Justice 2, you were cast as Scarecrow?
That's Mr. Scarecrow to you, yeah.
So, if you were offered to play Mr. Scarecrow in a live-action role, like, say, a TV show or a movie, would you be up for it?
I'm up for anything. Yeah. They have to pay me more whenever I wear makeup. It's just a thing. It's something I've earned over the last 50 years. When you guys see me, when you see me on Criminal Minds or on Bones, or you see me on a just doing a regular acting role in a movie, I'm just Robert Englund, basic character actor, nothing fancy. But you know, if I'm in a horror movie or in makeup, I make a pretty penny, as they say, because I'm a genre star, and it's international. It's the big happy accident that happened that they never teach you this in school, but I became international overnight. V was an international success. And then while I was doing V, Nightmare on Elm Street was the number one movie in Europe and Latin America and Asia. So I had two huge international hits. International audiences don't pick up on everything that we love. We have some rock and roll, we have some comedy stars and television stars. They don't know who they are in Europe. They don't care. Just like if I had to ask you guys to name five famous German comics, stand-up comics right now. I'll bet nobody here could do that. And it's the same for them. They don't know a Jay Leno or something like that. That's our topical American humor on late night TV. By the writers, we just did a reading of the original draft of Dream Warriors at Whiskey A Go-Go. I literally was sitting, you know, where Axl Rose and Jim Morrison's butt had sat, and we were practicing, and we put it on. But I was looking at the script, I forgot. That was written by the guy that wrote Shawshank Redemption. This is the kind of talent that New Line Cinema was hiring back then, you know. And I just, whenever I take credit for a couple of those lines, you got to remember that most of the great lines that you love from those films were done by our very gifted young writers.
Great question. Thank you.
You'll see us soon in Stumptown 2, the untold story.
All right, that is going to do it for day one of Rose City Comic Con 2019. What a blast! It was so much fun walking around the vendors floor. We sat in on a couple panels. Awesome. I love Robert Englund. He is amazing. Anyway, I'm going to head home. I have a slight headache coming on. Got to go get something to eat. I will see you guys again in the next video, which for me will be tomorrow. For you guys, it'll be up on Wednesday. All right. Thanks so much for watching. I'm tongue-tied. Okay. Bye.